What's up, everyone? We're back today for another tough workout. So today what we're going to focus on is the upper body, the core, and getting the heart rate elevated. So all you're going to need today is a jump rope, some heavier dumbbells, and a moderate pair of dumbbells. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get warmed up here. I'm gonna grab my jump rope. If you don't have a jump rope, go ahead and do a little run in place. So I'm just gonna start off with 50 jumps. 10. 20. 30. 40. 50. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and set that down. Next, I'm going to do a nice wide lunge, and then I'm gonna put my outside hand on the ground, my inside elbow, I'm gonna rotate toward the ground, and then just rotate up. I'm gonna alternate, same thing, other side, rotate toward the ground, rotate up. One more time, and as we're doing these, so this is gonna stretch my hamstring, my lats, what else? Glute. Okay, all right, next. What I want you to do, turn the feet out slightly, get in a deep squat here. So I'm gonna squat down. I'm gonna have my elbows in between my knees, and I'm just gonna kinda pry my legs even a little further apart. And then once I'm there, one hand down, rotate up, holding. Other hand down, rotate up. Okay, just kinda shake it out. One more time, I'll give you the side angle here. So feet slightly wider than shoulder width. Sitting into that deep squat, spacing out, hand down, rotate up, some small circles forward, and again, we're just getting the blood flowing, getting the muscles activated, get ready to kick some butt. Ooh, and I forgot to mention also stability ball today. If you don't have a stability ball, it's actually all right. There'll be ways to get around it, but we're gonna use the stability ball. All right, so first things first, we're grabbing the stability ball and we're going to do a plank on the ball, and then we're going to extend forward, draw back in to the side, diagonally drawing back in, the other side, draw back in. So while I'm in this movement, some cues here before we start. Don't want to hyperextend my back, don't want my butt up too high, okay? It's just a small little extension, back in. I don't need to extend my arms all the way out like so. So we're going to do 10 of these. Here we go. Starting off. So, extend forward. Diagonal. Other one, that's one. Four, and this is a good one. Core stability. That's two. Three. Four. Also, this kind of slower to moderate tempo is a lot more challenging and effective for my core. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine and 10. Burning, feeling that. All right, so next we're gonna go ahead and grab those heavier dumbbells and we're going to rest on the stability ball and we're gonna do the chest press. So I'll just give you a quick little demonstration of the movement. So when I'm on that ball, I'm scooting forward, my head's resting on there, okay? So hips are up in the air. They don't have to be all the way up where I'm hyperextending my back, okay? So up, drawing the belly button in toward my spine, flexing my glutes. And then we're gonna do the chest press. I'll give you a front view for this. So instead of back at 90 degrees, actually the side view might be better. I'm gonna slightly angle it, okay? Boom, chest press. So I'm gonna go ahead, grab those dumbbells, those heavier dumbbells. I'm doing 12 of the press. Whew. Let's do this, here we go. So I'm set in place. One. Two. Four, five, 6, 7, keep the core engaged, 8, 9, 10, 11, and last one, 12. Ooh, that was tough. All right, setting one of those down. Go ahead and hold on to the other dumbbell, and next we're going to do the windmill. So the windmill, my feet wider than shoulder width, okay? The side that I'm gonna go toward, my foot is angled that way, my other foot slightly pointing that direction. The side I am bending toward, I'm gonna bend that knee, plant leg's gonna stay extended. So we're gonna bend from this 90 degree angle with your hip, touch the dumbbell behind your foot, and draw back up. All right, so we're doing 12 each side. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, and again, try not to use your shoulder to muscle this weight up, okay? So we want the activation coming from our oblique. You're also gonna feel it in your hamstring a little bit. 6, and obviously the heavier the dumbbell you use, the more challenging it would be. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and the last one, 12, other side. Here we go, that was tough. 1, I'm gonna space my feet out slightly, make it a little more challenging. 2, also, my heels are pretty much lined up, so if there were a line behind me, they would both be on that line to give you an idea of where your feet should be planted. 6, 7, 8. Again, I'm feeling it here, a little bit on the inside. 9, 10, 11, one more, and 12. That was tough. All right, next, grabbing a medium to semi-light pair of dumbbells. We're gonna do the uppercuts, okay? So the uppercuts, if we're boxing, okay, would be in our stance. So the movement's gonna start on my foot and from my hip. I'm gonna drive up, right? Boom. I'm getting that slight rotation as well, okay? So if I only use my arm, I'd tire out and I wouldn't generate as much power. So we're gonna use our hip, our oblique, and just pop, pop up, boom, 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 okay? So I'm grabbing those dumbbells, here we go. We are doing 15. So once we do each side, that counts as one. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. All right, setting those down. And now I'm gonna grab the jump rope again. We have 200 jumps now that we're nice and warmed up. 200 jumps, yeah. Let's get right into that. Whew. Here we go. 10. Oh, not starting off well. 20. 30. 40. 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, halfway there, 10, 20, let's keep your front view. 30, 40, whoa, shoulders are getting tired, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 200. All right, set that down. Next, we're gonna get in that same position that we were in for the chest press, only now we're gonna grab one heavy dumbbell and we're going to do the tricep extension. So when I do that tricep extension, I'll just grab the dumbbell here. Okay, so I'm resting. So I personally have one hand on either side of the dumbbell, okay? I'm gonna flex back, extend. If that doesn't feel comfortable, you could hold it like so, okay? And flexing, extending, all right? So whatever feels natural. Or you could take two lighter ones, you could have one in each hand, it's your choice. All right, I'm gonna hold on to one, here we go. We are doing 15, here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. And actually, you know what? I'm gonna switch up my grip because I'm not feeling it targeting my tricep all that much. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. All right. Felt a little more that time. Next time I'm gonna actually try two moderate dumbbells. See if I like that better. All right. Next, we're going to do the flexions on the stability ball. So for this one, I'm just gonna prop up two weights here. And we've done these before. Just a quick little demo. Okay. Staggering my feet. Finding that spot on the ball. I'm gonna flex up, back down. Here we go. Two, three, four. We're doing 15. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Other side. Here we go. Right into it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. All right. Next, now I'm grabbing some dumbbells, the moderate dumbbells here, and we're going to do a squat. Then we're up, we're gonna curl, and we're gonna jump and press, all right? Here we go, 15 of these. One, two, also on that press, I'm generating that power with my legs to help get up there. Five, so I'm not just muscling it with my shoulders. Seven, eight, nine. Also, I'm maintaining that neutral grip on the press. 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. All right, setting those down. We're back up at the top. The plank where we extend the ball. Quick sip of water. Also, leave a comment down below if you're still with me about the counting. Jake is about to train this client that doesn't like when he counts, so let me know your thoughts on that. Yeah. And if you don't like that I count, don't watch my channel. One, because I don't care. Two, it's my channel, not yours. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. Grab the dumbbells for the chest press. Here we go. Scooting forward, resting the head on there, hips up. 12 of these. One, two, now we're banging them out. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and 12. Yeah, digging deep on that. All right, set one down. Keep one in your hand, the windmill. Now that we know the movements, I'm going right into these moves. One, two, three. This one's tough, four. If you do it properly, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, two more, 11, and 12. Also, we're working different planes here. That's why there's a method to the madness. I don't just throw these exercises randomly in like, oh, let's do this. I'm thinking about the different planes. We want to target different movement patterns, muscle groups, all that good stuff. Four, five. I know there's some channels out there that don't do that, and they just throw together a bunch of garbage. Not gonna mention any names though. Nine, 10, Jake knows what I'm talking about. 11, 12, I'll let him mention names. All right, next, grab those medium dumbbells. We're doing the uppercuts. Here we go, 15, one, give you a side view, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Send it down to the jump rope, 200 jumps. Oh, also, if you guys see this green color on my shoes, I was thinking about changing all my font to this color. Leave a comment if I should do that. I'm just kidding. Only a certain amount of people will get that one. 20. 30. 40. 50. 60, 70, 80, 90, halfway, 10, 20, oh, my arms are dying, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, and 90, 200. Oh my goodness, my shoulders are just burning. All right, grabbing, I'm gonna try the two moderate dumbbells now to do the tricep extension. Whew. Grab that stability ball, it's trying to run away. Whew. We're getting right into it. Whew. Here we go. Thrust our head on there, hips up. I'm gonna flex, extend, flex. Three, four, five, six, seven. Also, your neck should be relaxed. Eight, should be all scrunched up. Nine, 10, oh yeah, feeling it. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. It's all about form. Form first, folks. All right. Setting those down. Setting up the dumbbells. Doing the stability ball. Flexion. Here we go. Stability ball flexion. I think I'm still in frame. Am I still in frame? Yeah. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Other side. Ooh, now I have my trusty partner letting me know I am still in frame. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, because you gotta see my lovely face. 10, I can't face the wall again like last time. 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Yeah. All right, grab those moderate dumbbells, the squat, curl, jump, and press. We're doing how many? 15. Goodness, why did I choose 15? All right. Squat, curl, 1, 2, 3, 4. So again, even something as simple as the squat, thinking about the mechanics, you know, I'm trying to maintain proper alignment with my joints and body. 9, 10, 11, 12, 3 more, 13, arms are burning out, 14, and 15, all right, yeah, set those down, we're up to the last round, one more time through, all right, so we'll grab that stability ball, let's go. Let's not procrastinate. I have a client coming up in about an hour and a half here. I still have to shower, start editing. It's a whole process, so you all can watch this tomorrow. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. I forgot to get my drink of water though. I'm gonna take that right now. All right, quick sip. Oh, okay. That was good. The essence of life, water. All right, grab the 40s. And we're going to do the chest press again. Here we go. 11 and 12. All right, let's go ahead and set one of those down. The windmill, yay! This one's so fun. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Again, think about the muscle groups you're using in order to bring that dumbbell up. And don't just muscle it with your arm. Two more on this side. Oh, other side. Whew, this is tough. Still recovering from an injury, by the way. Going to the ortho tomorrow to find out the results, the MRI results. 2, 3. If you haven't been following me for a while, I was hit by a car while riding my bike. If you don't wear a helmet, you should wear a helmet. Because I had mine on. If I didn't have it on, my skull would be cracked open. 7, 8. I got Mr. Funny Guy laughing over there. He thinks that's funny that my skull is almost cracked open. Oh, wait till I throw a dumbbell at your head next time you're not looking, Jake. And we'll see how funny it is. Alright, the uppercuts. Uppercuts! I don't know what he's saying. He's saying something crazy over there. Alright, grab the dumbbells. Here we go. 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Oh, set those down. Jump rope. Jump rope. 200. Let's go. Last time on the jump rope. Done a lot of them. Oh, here we go. Oh, sweat just dropped right in my eye. The tank puts the tank. You're the tank? I don't know what he's trying to tell me. You can talk, Jake. I don't care. I don't care if you talk. Oh, yeah, that's right. Oh, duh. Oh, that's right. Actually, I forgot. Jake was actually ran over by a tank in the military. They were out on, what do they call that? Like a ruck run or what is that called? Anyway, he had done one of those long runs where it's like 20 miles and he was resting. He took his boots off because his dogs were stinking. And all of a sudden this tank rolled by and rolled over like three of his toes. Completely shattered the bone. Mr. Tough Guy decides he doesn't need to see the medic. So he just bandages up his toes himself. And then starts to get a gangrene infection. So he was out of commission for like, I don't know, probably a month or so after that. So that might teach you a lesson out there. Don't try to be too tough. All right. Right, Jake? He said, yeah. All right. 40 seconds. 40 left. Whew. That was good. That just took my mind off of what I'm doing. 20 left. Whew. 10 left. Whew. Oh. Oh, goodness. I didn't even make that last jump. So actually, that was 199. 200. There we go. All right. Oh, the tricep extension. Sweating. Let's go. I just want to be done with this now. Just want to be done. Here we go. Run the home stretch. Three more exercises. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. 11. 12. 13. 14. And 15. All right. The flexion on the stability ball. Set the dumbbells up so I can brace myself against something. We're doing 15 each side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Other side. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Last exercise. Grab the dumbbells. Squat, curl, jump, and press. 15. I wanna get done with this. I'm gonna be honest. I'm tired today. Here we go. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. So if you're still with me, if you got through it all, or about to get through it all, I should say, good job. This is not an easy one. I'm tired, I'm sweating a lot. That's good, right? Not too long, about a half hour or so. Focused on everything, upper body, heart rate, legs, all the good stuff. Two more. And last one. Oh, all right. Yeah, let me set these down. And I'm already cleaning up. There we go, that's how I do it. All right, so there you have it, folks. That was three rounds, eight different exercises. We focused on our upper body, our core, got the heart rate up, worked the power, the strength, all the good stuff you love. Thanks again for watching. Remember to leave comments, like, share, and always remember, you don't have to be an athlete to train like an athlete. Let's do it. Just in a while, feels good to get back. And again, just trying to maintain my looseness. That's probably the one of the most challenging things for me personally, just staying loose, staying nimble. But again, those snaps.